This is how you do it. Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. And spray. Oops. Hey Calaveras, what's up? Welcome to another adventure, welcome to another video. And today we have something very special. It's not that we are riding around, it's not that we are showing you around some places. Today we are gonna do ceramic coating to our motorcycles. So if you wanna learn how to do it, what are the products that we use, what's the process, we still haven't begun. So I don't know how this is gonna end, but hopefully it's gonna be a great thing for, you know, to help preserve the paint, especially for Jordi, because having a black motorcycle is very demanding. As you know, we live in Manhattan, so we don't own a garage. We don't own our own place, and we cannot do these kind of things in our own parking garage. So we had to come somewhere in Connecticut, usually like a hotel with a big parking lot. This is where we are right now, and this is where we are gonna do the whole thing. So we're very excited.
The first step, of course, is to clean up the bike. So that's what we're gonna do.
Right, so this was the first step, cleaning up. Right now we're going to the hotel and we're gonna start the process.
Step two is to decontaminate the surface of the painting. Step 2A is gonna be the chemical decontaminant. Step 2B is gonna be the clay bar. So let's use the chemical guys, decon iron remover. Okay, so now time for the physical decontaminant using the clay bar and of course the clay bar loop, both by chemical guys. The next step is gonna apply some compound to correct the painting. Come here, come closer. You can see some swirls from the cleaning with the microfiber towels. So what we're gonna do is correct it with the compound. Okay, so you see, now you can see the contrast with the bike. So just when you start rotating, you see, it's like powder, still dry, but as soon as I continue rubbing, it's getting drier and drier because of the heat. And that's what we're gonna remove with the microfiber towel.
I mean, we can do it manually because it's a motorcycle. If it were a car, you definitely need like a machine because otherwise it's too time consuming. There. Right now we are applying the polish, also from Meguiar's, and basically it's like we did with the previous step. It's like somehow applying makeup, like powder. So basically you start with little taps, and once the area is fully covered, you start with rotation, and later on you clear it with a cloth. No secret, just patience. Alright guys, the bikes have already been cleaned up, decontaminated, corrected and polished, and now we're gonna apply one final product before the ceramic coating, and that product what's gonna do is gonna remove any residual oil that may be on top of the coat. And that's the final touch before applying the ceramic coating.
It's called the IPA.
IPA, okay, like the beer. Ooh. So Jordi is still finishing with his polish. I'm done, so I'm gonna start with mine and show you how to do it. The IPA prep spray from Avalon King, which is the same brand that we are gonna use for the ceramic coating. It's been 3 hours so far since we started the whole process, like going to the, you know, to wash the bikes. Right now, we started at 3:30. It's almost 6:30 p.m. right now. And finally, we are ready to apply the sugar coat. No, ceramic coat. It comes in a very beautiful packaging. It looks like a cologne almost, or like perfume. So I'm gonna show you right now what it looks like, because it's a very beautiful bottle. You wouldn't expect that from that kind of product, but in the end, it's a chemical.
Apply, smile, enjoy. This is it. All the process, all the rubbing, all the chemicals, all the products, all the polish, blah, 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 to just be able to apply this thing, which is like, I don't know, maybe like a potion or something. It comes with everything you need to apply the product, jokes apart. So basically you have this block, which is like a foam block. And now what we're going to do is that we are gonna get this pad and wrap it like that, and then apply the product here and just put it on the bike from doing like stripes, not circles, stripes, up, down, and then side to side to make sure that you cover every single spot. And we're gonna work covering small areas because it's the first time that we do it and we are not experienced doing that. So this is all the recommendations that we found online.
See here now the rainbow color. That means that the ceramic coating is ready to be buffered. Looks pretty good. This is over. It's been a long process. Hopefully it will be worth it. It's getting dark right now. We're gonna wait 1 hour and do a second coat, and then we're gonna cover the bikes. They need to be without not being exposed to water, so we check the weather. It's not gonna rain, but just in case, we're gonna cover the bikes. We're gonna spend 1 day doing other things in the area, and we'll show you the results.
The next day.
It's been 24 hours since we finished the process and we just unveiled the bikes, and we are very satisfied with the overall results. Come take a look. We already talked about Jordi's bike because it was black. It has some swirls, no major scratch, just swirls from cleaning the bike. And as you can see, it's gone and it's extremely, extremely shiny. In terms of my bike, I think that overall it looks shinier, but in my case, I was very surprised with the chrome. I think it looks awesome. I didn't have any scratches. I didn't have any swirls. Probably I did, but you couldn't see, you couldn't tell because it was white. But look at the chrome. It's amazing how this looks. It looks better than when I picked it up from the dealership. Basically, we're gonna talk to you as our final takeaways about three things. Time that we invested doing this, the application itself, and then the overall results and price to see if it's worth it. In terms of time, I'm gonna say that it's a little time consuming. It took us about 3 hours, mm-hmm. But technically the application of the ceramic coating, it was about 25% of that time.
Yes.
It was mostly the time consuming thing part. It was mostly preparing the bike, preparing the coat for the ceramic coating.
Yes. So remember that you have to clean it up, decontaminate, correct the imperfections, apply the IPA to apply before the ceramic coating, and then the application of the ceramic coating itself. The only thing that I would mention is that I think, I have the feeling that this product, the tools that they give you, are more prepared for the application on a car. Basically because they give you a rectangular block that it's flat, and in that, in our case, for a motorcycle, the application needs to be in rounding, in round
surfaces.
Here, when you do the deposit, you still try to do this hashtag application, and it's weird because everything is rounded. But other than that, I think it's super, super, super easy.
Yes. And in terms of price and overall results, I think we are extremely satisfied. I think we paid less than under $200. So basically, if you go to your dealership or to a paint place to get it done, it can be, depending on where you live, around $700, $800, $900, under $1,000, but close to $1,000. So we paid $200. And I think that if you like DIY projects, it's worth it, and it's not that hard to do it, and you save some money. But I have also, we were talking about it, and I think it's also important to know that our bikes were almost brand new. So that means that there were no major scratches, we didn't have any accident or fall. The elements, we keep them in a garage, so they were pretty neat. It was pretty easy to get them prepared. So this is also something that you need to keep in
mind. My bike was a little bit more damaged, quotes damaged, because it had only swirls, soft swirls, because they call it the excessive taking care swirls, because you do the swirls when you try to clean it up. Of course, it still has some of them, but of course I did all the polish and all the compound by hand, so we don't have the machine, but I think it pays the difference a lot.
I think that overall, we're gonna give it, I don't know, out of 5 stars, what would you say?
I mean,
I think 4.
I want to say 4.5 or 4.75.
There's always room for improvement, but...
Always, but yes. I mean, once again, the product itself, the ceramic coating itself, I think it's a 5 out of 5.
Yes, definitely. So don't overthink it. If you have a dark colored bike that has some minor things and you want it to look clean and perfect every day, I think this is the right product for you. Again, we are not sponsored or anything. Jordi just spent some time doing some research on the internet, and it came that this was the best option in terms of money and time and everything.
And quality.
So I think that if you are looking for a ceramic coating that you want to do on your own, just check the description and check the products that we use and do it.
Okay. Stay tuned.
Yes.
As always, saludos. Siempre nube.
Bye.